wanted to make a film about the topic of home, because I think it's a very important universal topic at the moment in the whole world. And because I wanted to make a film really about this personal feeling of home, this idea that you feel that you belong somewhere rather than the political context of countries and borders, I decided to focus myself on culture. And that's how I met Sipa Labajwa and many other artists that also appear in the film, people who are, you know, working with creative tools. I wanted to find artists because I wanted to talk about the topic of what is a home, or what is a home country, which is of course very abstract and not very cinematographic. I wanted to find artists to collaborate with, and one of the first people I came across was Sipa, and I was extremely happy when I saw what kind of work he's making. So I wrote him a letter saying, would you be prepared to work with me on this film? And of course he said no. So I had to go back to Abkhazia to convince him. And when I sort of started to make him understand that in fact making this film could also be beneficial for his idea that he wanted for Abkhazia to open up, for people to open up, to the borders to open up, and people to start thinking much broader than just this small idea of Abkhazia. No, it hasn't really changed, because I started to make the film because I have this idea about home. Because I am with one foot in Holland, with one foot in Georgia, I have felt much, much more complete since I started to travel, since I lived in London for 6 years, since I moved to Berlin for a year, you know, I was in Paris for a bit. So then, you know, you start to understand that home for everybody has a completely different connotation. But for me as an artist, the things that I do is basically my home, and in this Sipa and I are finding each other. Well, Abkhazia is on the Black Sea. It was an autonomous republic within the Soviet Republic of Georgia. And when the Soviet Union collapsed in the beginning of the 90s, there, of course, all these countries wanted to have their independence, and it created a lot of conflicts in the region, in South Caucasus. The majority of the population of Abkhazia was Georgian. So, of course, when the Abkhazians won the war, a lot of refugees, the big stream of refugees started, and the country became very empty. And that's, for instance, why they started also to sort of find or invite back people that had left Abkhazia 200 years ago, like, for instance, the Syrians that you see in the film. So it's a very small but multicultural society within the South Caucasus, which is my second home. Already for 30 years. Just very briefly about the situation there is that the Georgians, because Abkhazia is completely depending on Russia for finance, for food, for pensions, for state budget, everything. Also because Russia is the only country that has recognized Abkhazia. And so the war between Abkhazia and Georgia has, especially since the recognition, been blamed on Russia completely. And in this whole discussion, to my feeling, the Abkhazian people, they have been forgotten. And what is very interesting, when I was able to show this film at last autumn at the Tbilisi Documentary Festival, is that there was a very heated and long discussion, and people actually, let's say in general, I feel that my position as an outsider actually benefited. I benefited from that because I could present them something which was not biased and which was not within a kind of political agenda. And that made that people actually, it opened the eyes of a lot of people who are fed by media with different things, with different opinions, and they get this completely different view on something, which I think is opening up their minds and ideas as well.